Section 13.3 is a hyperbola. Hyperbola is the pair of two problems. And they either open up, down, or right and left. So it's a pair of two problems. And on that formula page, you see I have two pictures here. One that open left and right, or up and down. In case of left and right, the formula starts with x to the power of 2. So one of the main differences between ellipse and hyperbola is, for ellipse, it has a positive sign, but in hyperbola, there's a negative sign between x2 and y2. If the hyperbola open up and down, then we start with y2. And the equation of the asymptote is, the asymptote is the line, or these two lines, that the parabola is tangent to it. It won't touch it, but it would be tangent to it. So for that, when there is a problem of hyperbola, you should see whether it's right or left, or up and down. Now, one way to tell is, like in this case, it starts with x to the power of 2. So we know if it starts with x, then would be this kind, right? Or it could be the other one. But how could you tell? Is this, or this one is start with x2 or y2? Now, if you don't want to memorize it, you could think of this way. In this equation, if I set x equal to 0, x equals 0 is where the parabola intersect the y-axis. See these points? These two points are x equals 0. But these two points are y equals 0. Like here, if I put x equals 0, if you notice here, y2 become a negative, and that's not right. So in that case, it means that you must have y equals 0 in this equation. When you put y equals 0, then x2 is equal to 4, or x is positive minus 2. That's how we could tell, if you don't want to memorize, whether the hyperbola is right, left, or like in this one. See, it starts with y, right? So if I set x equals 0, then this part is gone, then y is plus or minus 6. So that means x has to be 0. X is 0 means you have your hyperbola intersecting the y-axis. So now, the third situation is a hyperbola in non-standard form. This is non-standard form, like x, y equal to c. It's not in fraction form. And there is an example here. The way to solve it is, if you divide both sides by x, then you have equation of y equal minus 8 over x. It's not very clear here. And this is just the equation of a straight line. The only difference is x cannot be 0. When x is 0, then 8 over 0 is undefined. Means at x equals 0, which in fact is the y-axis, there is a cut. There is not a continuous. X equals 0 is not defined because it gives the value of y equals 0. So your graph starts from the left, but when we reach to the 0, there is a cut. So this is actually a line, which in this case is the asymptote, which cut the parabola from continuous to discontinue. So you always have one of these three cases when you want to do your homework. Like in this one, see? The graph the symbol. So which one is this? Well, y equal 2 it start with y equal 2 start with y equal 2 so is up or down. That's this kind of problem. Okay, This one started with X, X2. When it starts with X2, then it's right and left. So you have to take your proper pictures on that one. And then continue. And this one, again, it starts with Y2. Start with Y2 is up or down. So see which one is up and down. It's probably this one. And this is the other case that we discussed, very similar to that example. So first you have to write it in this case, and then you graph it. And then this is equation, this is a situation number five, that this equation is given, and they ask us to tell whether it's a parabola, ellipse, hyperbola, or not. What I did was I grouped them together, X and Y, and you know, we practiced in the past that you could take this three, and it's X minus six to the power of two, and you take this three, and that would be Y plus one, plus five to the power of two, and take everything else to the right. So basically, we end up having equation of the circle. And then these are some that they ask you to tell which one is it, that for the practice, I have the answer at the end of this, right after this page, you got to look to see which one is it. Number 10 and 11, again, you have to work with the equations. So what we can do here is we just move 6x to the other side, kind of simplify it, and this is the problem. Or on the second part, see, on number 11, what I did was first, I brought all the terms to one side, simplify, then group them, you know, these two, I add two positive two, minus two power two, these two, half of 10 is five, so five to power two, minus five. And then this three is that. So I end up having a circle. And this is a page that has the solutions for those multiple choice questions.